Never mind where. Just get your clothes on and come with me.
Oh, God. Come on. God, not the cellar. Not the cellar. Please, God, not the cellar. It's so cold and dark there.
No, 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 Danny. I'm going to take you to a place that's warm and where there are people we can talk to.
I don't want to leave you. Why do I have to talk to anybody else?
We haven't any choice, Daniel.
Yes, we do. We have choices. You said we deny everything. If we're very careful, you'll never find out our secrets. You'll never find us.
Now, come on, Daniel.
Yes, give me the police, please. Someone's broken in my apartment. Well, 21H. The address. Well, 525 West 83rd. Daniel Blank. No, I'm in no physical danger.
That's me.
Hi, Cal Roberts.
Oh, I've been expecting you. Come on in. Louise, this is Cal Roberts from the ad agency.
How do you do?
Pleased to meet you, Miss Jefferson.
Now, if you'll excuse me, I'll leave you two alone to talk business.
Wait, why don't you stay? I've got an idea that I want to throw at Mr. Jefferson, and I'd like to see what you think.
Who do you care what she thinks?
Women are a very important part of the consumer market, you know.
Sure, I knew that. I was just testing you.
Good, good. I like that. Like a man who doesn't take me at face value. Now, Mr. Jefferson.
Just call me George. Anybody's gonna help me beat that honky? I mean, that whitey.
I know what you mean, George, and don't be afraid to say honky around me. In fact, I would like you to think of me as a brother.
You as a brother?
I told you not to take me at face value. Seriously, though, when I'm working on a campaign, I like to identify completely with my client.
Okay, Roberts, you're a brother. Oh, yeah. Okay, you're a brother. Now, that's TCB.
TCB?
Take care of business.
Oh, yeah. R.O., George.
R.O.
Right on.
Why don't we all sit down?
Thank you. Now, George, we're brainstorming your problem over at the agency, and we decided that you've got to fight fire with fire.
You mean burn down Cunningham's store?
No. Look, Cunningham is cashing in on the revolution and our forefathers at Independence Hall. So why don't you do the same thing?
Because our forefathers didn't have nothing to do with the revolution. They weren't even nowhere near Independence Hall.
And if they were there, they weren't voting. They were dusting.
Wrong, Mrs. Jefferson. There were lots and lots of black patriots in the American Revolution. Like, for instance, just off the top of my head, there was Crispus Attucks in 1770 at the Boston Massacre.
Oh, yeah, I always liked him. You know, he's the one that said, don't fire until you see the whites.
George. No.
It's all right, sister. I'm a brother, remember?
You got a plan, Robert?
Have I got a plan? What if we could tell everyone that they could get their clothes clean by the great-great-great-grandson of Thomas Jefferson?
Great, where are we going to get him?
He's right here.
Now you're not going to be sick, and you know it. You just stole, and it ain't going to do you any good. This is going to happen no matter what.
Oh, please don't do that. Please go away. I won't tell nobody you was here.
Lady, I want you to tell everybody I was here.
We can't do this. We're strangers.
Yeah, but we ain't going to be strangers for long.
You hurt me.
Look, lady, I don't want to hurt you. Just cooperate a little, okay?
Wait a minute. I got to go.
Go where?
To the bathroom. Honestly, I do. It'll only take a minute.
Okay, okay. Go.
Where are you going?
You going to the bathroom? I'm going with you.
I'll wait till tomorrow.
Scream, lady! Lady, in neighborhoods like this, nobody answers a scream for over an hour. Believe me, I know.
What's that for?
Lady, I'm gonna tie you up.
Now, here we are. Oh. Ah, beautiful, huh? Just like a mountain stream there.
Yeah, with a dead fish floating in it.
Make the punch
in it. This thing stinks. Can't you go home and get your
bowl? Make the punch in this. Oh. I don't want...
Why did you do that?
You did it! Get away! You meathead, you! Now I gotta go home and make up some excuse to get my own punch bowl out of my own house. Dope.
That's Barney Hefner's dog. Oh, he only barks at Archie. Archie's coming home.
Lady, I don't believe you.
Yes, he is. It's true. He only barks at Archie. Archie!
Hey, Edith. You got the door locked, Edith. Come on, I gotta get in there.
Archie, tell him you're gonna be there in just a minute.
I'm gonna be there in just a minute.
Come on, Edith, hurry up. I gotta get in the house for something, eh?
You see this? Now, you're gonna let him in. And then you're going to get rid of him really fast. Otherwise, you're both going to be dead.
Hey there, come on, will you?
Come on.
Hey there, I got to get something in there.
Come on, let's go.
Gee, why you got this door locked?
I'm going to be right in here. Now, you get rid of him.
25 years, I beg you to lock the door. And one time
right
I don't want
here,
the door
Archie
locked, you got it locked there. Why did you do that? And look at this, the chain on the door. Don't be waving at me. Get the chain off of the door. Come on.
Archie.
Thanks.
Why ain't you babysitting with Joey?
Joey's going to be okay for 2 minutes. I got to get something over here.
Archie.
It's this punch bowl, you see? I bring it over there because they ain't got nothing over there to make the... I mean, the meathead killed the fish, see? And you remember the bowl we gave him there for the man of voice? Well, I don't want to make a long story out of it either, but so let me just get over there. Don't cry. It's only a fish, a little goldfish. They only cost a dime each, eh? Keep doors closed, Edith.
Oh, she...
Okay. Okay. That was really good. You did that really well. Really good.
Now, wait a minute.
What?
Couldn't we do this without kissing?
Yeah, okay. But you're going to change your mind.
Well, there's something burning in the kitchen.
What is it?
It's in the kitchen.
All right, come on, come on, come on.
There's something burning in the kitchen. Oh, there's a fire! Fire!
But...
Oh, my birthday cake! My birthday cake is burning!
Ladies, get rid of it. Get rid of it.
You set the challenge. How can he fight?
Tell him, Borelli.
Well, under ordinary circumstances, if a principal withdraws or is unable to appear, then his second is expected to substitute for him.
You see?
All right. I will. No, but these aren't ordinary circumstances. No, I won't permit this.
Just a minute, Borelli.
Now, what are you going to do?
Have breakfast?
No, you understand, Leone, that if I go and take your place...
Not my place, Guido, yours.
All right, have it your way. Mine. But if I do that, you're going to be the laughing stock of the whole town.
He's right. You'll be completely dishonored. But you can laugh. Publicly disgraced, and you can laugh.
I can laugh. Don't you see how I live here, where I live? Do you think I care what anyone thinks?
Come on, Borelli, we're wasting time.
But you really are going to fight.
You heard him. I have no choice.
Well, perhaps I can.
He knows it's up to him, Borelli. Believe me, he knows.
Now, that cynicism aren't at all. If you learn to rid yourself of sentiment, Borelli, and apply the force of logic, perhaps you'll understand.
Borelli, there's no more time to argue. Doctor, please, follows. Come.
See you. Goodbye.